Our old friend Pat Robertson is back, and this time he's answering a question about marrying your first cousin. Take a look.
This is Jennifer, who says, a close friend of mine believes that the person God wants her to marry is her first cousin. They are both committed Christians, and they even have received several prophetic words in favor of their union. Both families support it. There is a clear, powerful call of the Lord on both of their lives. What do you think?
Kissing cousin, hey, there's nothing. I mean, I don't know anything the Bible says a problem about marrying first cousin. Now look, here's the deal. If there are recessive genes and there are something in the family that would come out, if those two recessive genes come together, they might wind up with children that got some kind of disability. Mm-hmm. Other than that, there's no problem. There's nothing in the Bible that says you can't marry your first cousin. And if here you say everybody's in favor of it, all right, go for it. But I would check the genetics. Get some geneticist to check the DNA to see if there's
something. Just to be sure that
just to be sure. You don't want to have some mongoloid child or, I shouldn't say mongoloid, whatever.
Children with diseases sometimes
disease,
that you don't find out until after.
Yeah, there are all kinds of latent genes that don't show up unless they're two latent come together, and then you have a problem. Okay.
So goodness. Close. He was so close. I thought
to being
pretty
correct,
reasonable. Mongoloid.
Yeah.
Oh, Pat.
See, he was talking about recessive genes.
Totally.
Like there was
check
some
the
science.
DNA. Yeah, totally.
It's subtle, a reference to abortion if you know things go wrong.
Right, totally,
you know what
right,
I'm saying?
Right.
Like,
or at least birth control, like don't have a kid.
Right. And then he went to the mongoloid.
Then he went to
the
mongoloid.
To be avoided.
It was
be avoided.
A pretty good answer, though, except for like that. It was right. Pretty strong. I would object to the use of the phrase "both families want it," like the whole. Yeah. It's really just one family. That's the.
Oh.
That's
a,
oh yeah, that's right.
That's,
point, right.
That's the issue.
Point taken.
But yeah, it's but also, but like, even if he talks about that, like, even if the birth control or, like, then, I mean, I'm generally the whole purpose of getting married is to procreate. Mm-hmm. So he's acknowledging that they're. That they would get married for other reasons.
And he's right. Biblically, of course, as we've discussed many times on the show, like, for example, in Noah's Ark, they had to have sex with the sisters and the brothers and then eventually the cousins. So there's nothing wrong with it. Adam and Eve, same thing. Had to have sex with the sisters and the brothers and then the sister and then the cousins. So biblically, it's perfectly fine.
Did you guys know that 10% of those married in the world are married to their first cousin?
Isn't
that amazing?
10% of those married are married to their
that
first cousin.
One in 10 married couples you know. Married to their first cousin.
In the world.
In the world, yeah. So in the United States, it's frowned upon, right?
Yeah.
I do want to say it has been recent scientific evidence indicating that the likelihood of a child being born with certain disabilities because of incest is much smaller than we thought. So one study was actually published in the Journal of Genetic Counseling, and they said the risk of serious genetic defects like spina bifida and cystic fibrosis in the children of first cousin exists, but it is rather small, 1.7 to 2.8 percentage points higher than for children of unrelated parents. Okay, so it is higher, but it's not that significant.
Well, I mean, it depends. You know, that's all how you look at the percentages. I mean, it's a pretty low, obviously, depending on age and a zillion other things, but 1.7 to 2.8 percentage points higher. That's pretty significant if it goes from 0.5 to 3.5, which would be 2.8%. That's seven times more likely.
So they said that, let's say you compare a young, healthy couple with their first cousins, but you compare them to a woman who's giving birth in her 40s, the rates are comparable.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So that's kind of fascinating, too.
By the way, you think you don't know anyone who, you know, in America, you were joking around, that one in 10, et cetera. My grandparents are first cousins.
Really?
Yeah. Might explain a lot.
It does.